The best word to describe Santorini is magical. Or how about romantic? These whitewashed cubic-shaped houses are typical of the traditional architecture of the Greek Cyclades Islands, but here it's different because they're built on the inside rim of a volcano. You can arrive in a unique way on the back of a mule, riding up this steep slope to the village up on top, where you'll find beautiful restaurants, you'll find lots of shops and great scenery. Get ready for a visit to one of the world's most desired dream destinations. Well, we're at the great lookout at Santorini, one of the most beautiful sites in the world. So scenic, it's the second most photographed site in Greece after the Parthenon in Athens.
There's one main pedestrian lane and a couple of small side pedestrian lanes lined with shops. You can buy your postcards and t-shirts and more jewelry, of course. And you have a chance to just explore. You can't possibly get lost in this little village. It only goes for about a half a mile, and it's three narrow blocks wide, some steps up and down, and then you basically get to the end of it, and there's another panoramic viewpoint down there.
And you will certainly run into some wild animals during the visit. Ah yes, the famous street cats of Santorini. Throughout Greece, especially in the islands, there are many cats walking around, but here in Santorini, it seems like there's more cats than anywhere. There were so many pretty pussycats to see and play with that I plan to make a second movie all about the cats and the mules of Santorini. Life does not get much better than sitting on a terrace in Santorini, enjoying some meals and drinks with friends and looking out over that scenery. You have the village behind you, and there's a sunset happening out over the bay. It's spectacular. With a setting like this involving so many outdoor restaurants, terraces, walkways, and scenic views, you can understand why the sunsets of Santorini are one of the most exciting attractions of your visit. That peaceful bay used to be the central landmass of the island until it blew up in a massive volcanic eruption. This aerial view shows Santorini's three islands surrounding the bay that used to be the caldera of the volcano that erupted. And we see the location of the main town, Thera, that we will be exploring in the program. The islands are the remnants of the rim of the volcanic crater. Although there is a small airport, most travelers arrive here by ship, usually on a cruise ship. On a typical 5-day itinerary covering several islands, a most comfortable way to travel, and offers a dramatic preview look at Santorini, stopping for just half a day, but that's enough time to have a look around the main village. You can also get here by inter-island ferry, which is great if you're planning to spend a few nights on the island. For example, you could travel from Mykonos on the fast jet ferry boat in just over 2 hours. There is no dock for the cruise ship or passenger terminal along the narrow shore, so passengers are brought from ship to shore on local tender boats called schooners, which only takes about 10 minutes. Santorini is the most popular cruising destination in all the Greek Isles. In fact, it's got too popular to a point where the local government has put a daily limit on the number of cruise passengers allowed. Back in 2016, as many as 18,000 people a day visited the island, and the mayor said the island is saturated. It was too much, putting a strain on the island's infrastructure. And so they limited the number of passengers now down to 8,000 per day. Tender boats drop you off at the Skala Marina, right next to the cable car station. And that's one easy way to get up the 700-foot high cliff. Or, for a more exciting trip up, you can ride a mule. This famous mule ride is one of the special attractions of Santorini. Mules and donkeys have worked here for many centuries, hauling goods and people from the shoreline way up to the settlements up on top of the hill. The roads were always too rough for any kind of a cart or wagon, and later on for trucks, and so the mules and donkeys have always borne the burden of hauling the stuff up and down the hill. They are responsible for the creation of these towns, because without them, no towns could have ever been built up here. With increasing concerns for animal welfare, the government has banned tourists who weigh more than 100 kilograms, or 220 pounds, from riding the mule. And if a large person gets on, they could be fined as much as $32,000. The cable car provides a more scenic lift with an excellent view. With the big increase in the number of tourists here starting in the 1970s, they realized they needed to build a cable car, which opened in 1982. It can carry 1,200 people per hour on a trip that takes only 3 minutes. And some of the profit from the cable car is given to the mule drivers to recognize their hard work and effort to keep that tradition alive. Or you could walk up the 600 steps, or perhaps better yet, walk down when you're finished with your visit. This main town, called Thera, consists largely of pedestrian lanes lined with shops and restaurants, which I'm going to help you explore right now. Everybody gets off the cable car and shuffles along, but look to the right and you will find the best viewpoint on the island. Put your friends in front and you've got a postcard view. Looking out at this amazing scene is one of your top thrills of being here. You'll also enjoy exploring this residential section. It's where the local people live, and many of these units are bed and breakfasts and small hotels. And the other nice activity is just taking a stroll through the lanes, looking at the shops, the buildings, the people. Take a walk. The main part of the village is only about 600 meters long, three narrow blocks wide, so it's really quite easy to walk around and see most of it in a few hours. Of course, a favorite activity of many travelers is shopping. And these little stores are really a lot of fun. Some of them are unique boutiques with handmade items. And then you've got your normal range of typical Greek souvenirs. You can get books, calendars, postcards, little bronze statues, Byzantine icons. You can get dolls and imitations of frescoes. Of course, clothing of all types. Pottery, soaps, and tablecloths, and other handmade items. And of course, these merchants are multilingual, so no matter where you're coming from, they'll be able to communicate and sell you something. Like natural sponges harvested locally. They are super absorbent. Greeks are also famous for their special golden jewelry, maybe a necklace with the meander pattern. Or perhaps you are just a window shopper or somebody walking by shooting video like me, and that's okay too, they're used to that. And you'll work up an appetite for at least a snack, maybe a meal, especially nice at a terrace restaurant. Then get away from the shops and detour back down to the residential neighborhood. It looks like an impenetrable maze, but really it's quite simple. There's several lanes that will take you right through it. Many of these homes are dug right into the hillside, which gives them added space and insulation from the weather. They're cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter. They also gain more space by using the rooftops. Nearly all of those flat roofs are outdoor patios. It's an efficient use of space in this kind of high-density but low-rise community. And the weather is quite mild all year round, so they can get a lot of use out of these open-air spaces. Rent a room here and live like a local.
Santorini is one of the most beautiful of all the Greek islands, certainly one of the most famous places. And behind me you see the capital village of Thera. There's a lot of cafes and restaurants on these terraces, so it's a great place to sit and have a drink, have some coffee, have a snack, or you can have a meal. The restaurants are quite good here, of course. And they specialize in a local red wine that they grow. The hillsides of Santorini are covered in vineyards. The village of Thera spills down the hillside from the top of the volcanic caldera, and it presents a stunning, picturesque sight. One of the slight problems with the village on the hill is there's a lot of stairs to climb, but it's worth it for the scenery. So up we go.
There are nearly hidden staircase alleys that connect all of the main pedestrian lanes. It's like a big three-dimensional jigsaw puzzle. Another good reason for walking through this residential area is to get the different views from various angles. Typical of Greek villages, there are many small neighborhood churches. It's tempting to get that view from the cliff, but don't get too close to the edge here, and just be careful when walking around. It took a lot of work to build this terrace town, and it also takes a lot of effort to maintain it, especially when you've got to haul things up by hand. And you'll see quite a few artistic touches in the building, such as the mosaic pavings being created here. Many of the homes have private courtyards, providing a small garden space.
The island is a small island, just has two main villages. There's Ea and Thera, and there's scattered settlements on the rest of the island as well. It's very comparable to Mykonos, and similar to Mykonos are all the whitewashed houses, but here the difference is the village is on top of the mountain rather than right along the coast as we found in Mykonos. It's one of the most popular spots for the visitor in all of Greece, and you can see why. It has a real magical quality to these whitewashed buildings. They're all white, as typical of the Cycladic architecture. The village of Thera is the largest village in the island, and the smaller town is Ea, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. We're showing you that as well in this look at Santorini today.
We're taking a quick ride out to Ea Village for a brief look at this beautiful spot. Now, you can organize a day trip from your cruise ship, or when in Thera, you could purchase a little tour, or you could rent a car to get out there. You'll find it a charming little village and much less crowded and busy than Thera, so it could be worth your while if you have the time. And then return back to Thera town for some more explorations. By now, it might be getting dark, and I'd like to introduce you to another side of Thera town. It's the main street. There's cars, there's people, there's motorcycles, there's trucks going by, and a lot of restaurants with lower prices than you're going to find in the terrace restaurants that overlook the view. So if you want to get a cheap gyros, or do some more shopping, or just take a stroll and see maybe the real backside of Thera, come on over to this main street and take a stroll. It's the kind of place that's backstage. It's the real town that you might not see if you're just walking around for 3 hours looking at the shops and enjoying the view that we've been seeing. But this is really also a lot of fun, and you'll get some better bargains down here, especially for the inexpensive foods. And there are some very friendly bars and coffee shops that will be very happy to welcome you. While we take a final look at evening shopping, let me give you a 30-second summary of 7,000 years of Santorini history.
The first evidence of habitation here was about 5,000 BC, and it was simple fishermen and farmers. Around the year 2000 BC, there was evidence of a Minoan civilization here. And then after the Minoans, there was a problem with the volcano. The volcano blew up. There was a huge eruption, and it blew away over half of the island. After the volcanic eruption, people moved back in slowly and gradually, and the island has been populated ever since. The whole cycle of Greek history was played out right here on Santorini.
You want to be sure to be here for twilight and sunset, the most magical time of day on Santorini. So if your ship is waiting, well, just catch the last tender back. You want to squeeze every minute out of this beautiful night. Twilight's that special time of day when you have that wonderful mix of natural and artificial lighting in perfect balance. And then eventually your visit is finished and you're going to have to tear yourself away from this wonderful place. Time to get back down to the ship, take the cable car in the dark down to the docks, into the tender, but don't leave yet. I've got a special surprise coming up in a moment. And then we looked up and saw a nice touch to accent the evening with a full moon as we approach our cruise ship. We are very fortunate to be able to hear the singing nuns of Santorini inside the Rosario Church of the Dominican Convent. The 12 nuns of various nationalities occasionally sing vespers that are open to the public, although most people don't know about it. So let's end our visit to Santorini in this divine and melodic way. Upload a new movie every week, so please subscribe to our channel and click that little alarm bell so you'll be notified. And if you enjoyed the movie, how about a thumbs up? And we always welcome comments down below. Or if you have questions about the destination, make note and we'll answer them. Thanks for watching.